Hey guys, it's Finn here, and today I'll be talking about my old setup versus my new and more advanced setup, and kind of compare the differences and see is it really worth it to spend more money to get a better look. So if you're just getting into filming skateboard videos and YouTube videos, I would go with this first setup. To film skateboarding, you need a camera, and for that, I would highly, highly recommend the Canon T3i. I filmed with this camera for over a year. I made many skate films, many snowskate films, so many YouTube videos I can't even count, and it's just a great camera. The only downside is that it shoots 720 and 60 frames a second, but I'll show you some clips, and the 720 actually looks really good with the fisheye. Speaking of fisheyes, for this beginner setup, I would recommend getting the Opteka 6.5mm. I did a whole separate review on this lens, so if you want to go check that out, it's over here. Now, for filming skateboarding, you also need a handle, and there's no other handle I would recommend as much as the Camcaddy Scorpion. Even if you just have a phone, this comes with a mount for using your phone, and also if you have a GoPro, it comes with a GoPro mount, and obviously the DSLR mount. I have so many good things to say about the Camcaddy Scorpion, so I'll be doing a whole other review on this thing later. Now this next part is kind of optional, but when you're filming skateboarding, some people choose to use a mic. I mean, the only sound that's really coming out of the camera is the wheels on the ground, so you don't need a super expensive mic, which is why I recommend the Rode Video Micro. This lens costs about $80 and it's worth every penny. If you're thinking about buying like an amazing Rode mic or just some other kind of shotgun mic, don't do it. It's just not worth it. Like I said, you're only filming wheels rolling on the ground and this is about as good as you need. Now an important attachment to use that mic on here is this little hot shoe mount. This mount, in my opinion, is a little bit overpriced. But it works great. You can find it on Amazon for about $25 Canadian. So that whole beginner setup is basically complete now. All you need is a memory card and a couple extra batteries. If you can't really afford the Canon ones, I would recommend getting the Power Extra batteries. They work amazing and you can't tell the difference between them and the actual Canon batteries. So the whole beginner setup will cost you about $750 Canadian roughly. And keep in mind that setup can last you years if you take care of it and you don't break anything. Like I said, I filmed a ton of stuff just using that simple setup, and it has worked perfectly for me. Next, let's get into a little more advanced setup that I actually use currently for filming skateboard videos. First off, let's start out with the things that are the same as the beginner setup, just because they're so good. Obviously, the Rode Video Micro, like I said, you don't need anything better than this, and the Camcaddy with hot shoe mount, that's all the same, just because they're so good, why would you replace them? These are things that you should only have to buy once, so when you do transfer to that more advanced setup, you don't have to switch out all your gear and start fresh. The last thing that is the same is the fisheye. Again, it's so sharp, it's so good, and it's really cheap, so you can't go wrong with that fisheye. Now, the things that are different. The main thing is the body I'm using. I'm using the Canon 80D, and the Canon 80D actually does shoot 1080 and 60 frames a second, which is super amazing. Also for this setup, I just recently purchased this light, which is super bright and it's going to be awesome for filming skateboarding. So this is a huge purchase you have to make if you're filming any street skating or even park skating when it's getting dark out. This is a must have. It's just so bright, so good. I'm already loving this. Also, I have two new lenses, the Canon 55-50mm and also the Sigma 17-50mm. And I also purchased two 64GB memory cards and three LPE6N batteries, which will last me literally for days. I've used one battery and I filmed 3 hours of skateboarding and it's not even dead yet. These batteries are amazing. I don't know why all the Canon cameras don't have them, but definitely stock up on those if you're going to be filming for multiple days and you can't always have the opportunity to charge batteries. Now, like I said, this setup is a lot more serious, so it will probably run you about $1,700. So make sure you're actually serious about filming YouTube, filming skateboarding, and all these things before you actually go and buy this setup.
Thank you.